This video gives you a general overview of how naming works in chemistry. This will be the first of a few videos that will go through into more depth on how to name substances in chemistry. It is very important that you learn how to name molecules, compounds, elements, acids, and hydrates to succeed in this course and any chemistry course. These series of videos will go into depth on each topic so that you can learn the material and be able to practice. If you look back to the matter section in your workbook, you'll see this classification of matter chart. It breaks down matter into pure substances and mixtures. Please take the time to distinguish between a pure substance and a mixture. Mixtures can be separated by physical means, while pure substances cannot. If you aren't sure, please go through your workbook again to review this difference. What we're going to focus on for this naming aspect in chemistry are the pure substances. And pure substances can be divided into elements and compounds. Please take a minute to distinguish between elements and compounds. If you're not sure, go to the matter page and review this material. Under pure substances, let's focus on the element. Well, what is an element? If it is anything on the periodic table, the most beautiful and important table in the whole universe, then it is considered an element. You cannot chemically break anything on the periodic table down to more simpler elements. Remember that many atoms make up an element. There are two types of elements, atomic and molecular. Atomic is a single atom by itself on the periodic table. And a molecular element is two of the same elements chemically bound together on the periodic table. There are seven diatomics that you need to look at on the periodic table. The seven diatomic elements that you must memorize and know are Brinckelhoff. Well, what is it? Well, if you write down all this, it's B-R-I-N-C-L-H-O-F, Brinckelhoff. Bromine, iodine, nitrogen, chlorine, hydrogen, oxygen, fluorine. These are all the seven diatomics that occur naturally in nature. So whenever you talk about any of these elements, you must have it as a diatomic. If this isn't easy enough for you to remember, there's another mnemonic for you to use. It's have no fear of ice cold beer. These are the seven elements also rearranged in another form. Another thing you must know of all the diatomics are the states of matter that they are in. All of them are gases except for bromine, which is a liquid, and iodine, which is a solid. What I want you to do is find the seven diatomic elements on this periodic table. Did you find it? Well, if you look at my periodic table, I've circled all the seven. Not looking at the hydrogen, all the nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine has a shape of the number 7. And notice where they are on the periodic table. They are all nonmetals all the way to the far right. Now, let's focus on the compounds. The next set of substances to be named are the molecular compounds. Molecular compounds are two nonmetals chemically bound together. They have no charges between them, and they share electrons. So I want you to take a look at the periodic table and find out where the nonmetals are. If any of these two elements come together, they are considered molecular compounds, and they use a different type of naming. The next set of substances to be named are the ionic compounds. Ionic compounds are when cations and anions chemically bound together. Cations are usually metals that are positively charged, which means that they lost electrons, or ammonium, which is NH4+, bound to a nonmetal, which is an anion, or polyatomic ions. And ionic compounds completely transfer electrons from the cation to the anion, and that is the distinguishing feature of ionic compounds. And lastly, we have acids. Acids are substances that has a proton, in the case hydrogens, that can be given off. And these hydrogens are in the front of the compound formula, and they have no charge. And so that is what the distinguishing feature of acids. So that is a general classification of naming elements and compounds. The next few videos will go into more depth on each type of naming.